and here to tell us more about the UKIP message for small business is our small business spokesman, Margot Parker, MEP.
Good afternoon, conference. I'm so pleased to be here today speaking to you for the first time as a member of the European Parliament. Now, whether my job here is to bring to close an excellent, excellent conference or to provide a warm-up act for the gala dinner, I'm not quite sure. But what I do want to say and what I do want to speak to you about is something which is really close to my heart, something that impacts on our country, our economy, far more than most people realize. And conference, we all know that the Conservative Party loves big business. Well, UKIP is all about small business, and that's what I'm here today to talk to you about.
Thank you.
The defence of our nation and to our education system, they're very important subjects. However, the importance and the impact of small businesses seems to feature so rarely that many fail to recognise just how crucial small businesses are to Britain. Not only are they the backbone of our economy, not only are they the principal driver of our labour market, but it is where our innovators can be found, our entrepreneurs, those people who once had a dream of making or creating or selling or trading. A group of people who once made a decision to take control of their own future and to build something for the benefit of themselves and those around them. And what I'm here to say to you today is that if you're one of those people, if you're working all hours that you can to start a business or to build a business, if you're a wealth creator, a generator of jobs, then UKIP are here for you. And make no mistake, we are determined to make your life easier. It's been interesting, this part of the debate on Britain's membership of the European Union. This coalition government has loved to dish out the quotes from big business. The CEO of this multinational, of that, somebody talking about the membership of the EU. Well, of course, it's important to them. I mean, they love it. You know, their friends are big business. They love the European Union, not because they think it's good for Britain, but because they think it's good for them. I know from talking to those hard-working Britons who are running small businesses up and down this country that they, like the rest of us, are struggling to find the cash that they need to help their business grow and to succeed, struggling to employ the people they need with the skills that are essential in an ever-competitive global marketplace, struggling to keep their heads over water. Wave after wave of unnecessary, overburdening legislation is swept over them. If we in this party, a party who truly believe in less regulation, are going to lead the way in supporting SMEs, then we need to do everything we can to put them first. And if you're in any doubt about why I'm going to tell you these following figures, then let me just quote this. SMEs account for almost half of the private sector turnover. 3.7 million businesses are sole proprietors. Small firms employ 59% of our workforce. 4.8 million businesses are micro businesses. conference, we need to start putting them first. Let me outline some of the ways that we believe we can help to that end. To start, UKIP will conduct a skills review, so crucial in allowing us to better inform our education system of the qualifications that they need to succeed in the workplace today. So often, when visiting local business owners, we're told that workers with the requisite skills and qualifications just don't exist in the UK labour market. Well, businesses looking to recruit and succeed aren't looking for university graduates with non-degrees in irrelevant subjects. They want people with skills, individuals who have the ability to demonstrate just more than experience at writing essays. They need more than that. We need to provide our education system with the intelligence they need so that they can better prepare people for the working world that's awaiting them. That's step number one. There are a number of EU directives which can be a burden, of course, to our small businesses. The Working Time Directive and Agencies Workers Directive, to name just two. Both are messy, ill thought out, and need to be dealt with. But of course, we in this party know that we can't. Why can't we? Well, because it's impossible as long as we remain in the EU. Once out of the European Union, we would restore common sense flexibilities, which would allow people in work more than that would create much more robust, flexible labour market. Now, UKIP will make it a priority to work with and to encourage local councils to provide more free parking in our town centres. As local authorities are squeezed from above, they have started to view our local car parks as cash cows, an easy way of bringing in revenue. How frustrating is that? Parking ticket machines are now designed to print solely specific tickets to a vehicle, a move designed solely to prevent the occasional good deed when handing on a ticket with just a little spare time as a good neighbourly deed. Well, they've killed all that, and we would like to see that change. UKIP will do all it can to bring an end to these charges altogether, which have been a hammer blow to small retail units in declining town centres. We don't need financial incentives and token reward schemes to revive our streets, our high streets. We just need a good dose of common sense, of UKIP common sense, and that's why we're here talking about this today. UKIP are going to push for simplifications to be made in the planning system to help bring about an environment that can benefit SMEs. It's ludicrous, it's downright scandalous that small business owners are left scrapping for business premises at a time when we have units lying empty, numbering in their thousands. Unnecessary bureaucracy is causing business owners to jump through hoops to satisfy archaic planning legislation that requires a simple change of use from A2 to A1. Well, UKIP would seek changes within that system, making it easy to marry up small business owners with vacant properties. UKIP will extend the right of appeal to HMRC for micro businesses with the provision that no action is to be taken by HMRC on micro businesses until all appeal processes are complete. And we've heard countless examples of good practice from HMRC where a little understanding and patience goes a long way. Well, we want to encourage and expand on that practice. In UKIP, we understand that business is about long-term planning and cash flow, whilst always, always encouraging businesses to maintain an open and honest dialogue. It's just as important to ensure that reciprocal support is paramount to what HMRC do. Bank lending to small firms needs to be made far easier with better access. I mean, we need business angels. We need new forms of finance. We absolutely need peer-to-peer lending. And I want to tell you a little bit about crowdfunding. It's a very good system. This is where small investments are made by private individuals through a broker, and it's just the sort of community effort which UKIP endorses, as it doesn't actually entail giving away large slices of precious equity. Just the interest on the funds are payable by the investee company. It is interesting to note that this form of small business finance has just reached £2 billion, twice as much as the coalition-backed so-called Green Bank, based in Edinburgh, and very much trumpeted by Vince Cable recently. We know, because we've been told so often, that cash flow is crucial to small businesses. We must see a change to the scourge of late payments by public and private organisations. Yeah. Restricting cash flow to small businesses causes real hardship and, in some instances, leading to failure of business. This is a major problem which eats into the available cash that small businesses desperately need to expand. And finally, regulation. We're not just here to talk about how important small businesses are. UKIP understands their true importance. We're going to fight harder than ever to see SMEs released from over-regulation. The main priorities for any business must always be to run and to grow their business. Time for them is very valuable, and it's paramount to actually implement and help people with this overburdening regulation. It's costing them far too much. Regulations have to be reduced, and they must start being relevant to small businesses. At present, most regulation works against growth and jobs. This is no encouragement for hard-working people. SMEs themselves tell us that regulation on employment, data protection, health and safety, all of those things are indeed a heavy burden. They want regulators to listen to what they have to say. How can it be right to impose one size fits all? I mean, we need legislation to be much more rigorous. We need it to be proportionate and evidence-based. And one of the things that makes me most proud to be part of UKIP is that, like you, I'm not a politician. I'm a businesswoman. I've worked in small companies. And before, actually, I was once sent to Brussels on their behalf to help make the case for a level playing field. Naively, I have to tell you, thinking that legislation could be simplified to help rather than to hinder. Conference. I can tell you from my own first-hand experience at the coalface, so to speak, there's never been any will to lessen red tape. Their only interest, really, has been finding ways of increasing it. Just another reason why we in UKIP understand the importance of taking back our independence and making our own laws. Conference. We all know that the Conservative Party are the party of big business. Well, I'm here today to tell you UKIP are the party of real business, and we're going to mean business as we take our message to the people of this country. Thank you very much.